you very much.
You're welcome.
It's a messy day.
Oh, I love your skirt. That's so pretty.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm doing well, thank you.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much. It's kind of you to say so.
I bet you're relieved.
That's true. The word finality.
Closure.
Oh, yes, indeed.
How are you doing?
Good morning, Mr. C. I'm fine, thank you.
Good morning.
Hello, good morning. Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate that a lot. Yes, it's nice to have it done. Indeed.
Absolutely.
That's fine.
And we hope we have four
people here this morning. We hope.
We do hope.
Yeah. You got copies?
Yeah, it needs copies.
Just please. Mm-hmm.
What did you get?
No copies. Do you need something?
I do.
All right. Thank you.
Well, I guess the courthouse is up and running, isn't it?
It is, what I understand.
Well, that's good. Our statue's not there yet, but it'll be a little while.
That'll give us another reason to have another dedication.
There you go, another one. What happened? Great, though.
I went upstairs to the top floor. Was that the to see one of the
that's where the courtrooms.
Yes.
Beautiful. Both very
absolutely
nice.
Really beautifully done.
Yep.
I thought the public benches were very nice.
Yep.
And the view.
Yeah.
And the view spectacular. I'd just like to go there.
Good morning, Mr. Seago.
Good to see you. Tisdale.
Before your meeting starts, I just wanted to share the latest edition of Georgia Sunshine Law, A Citizen's Guide to Open Government.
Right.
It includes the Open Meetings Act and the Open Records Act. So I've got several copies for every member of the board, and you're welcome to pass them out. And they're yours to keep. They're free. They're from the Attorney General's office. And they're just a very useful tool for government and citizens alike. So I'd just like
to
share them. I pass them out at a lot of boards.
Okay.
So.
And they're free.
Yes, ma'am. Sorry, no, sir.
That's good.
And I call on a cell and spray that like he does me when I'm late for work.
Is that what he does?
Are you working today? It's time for you to work.
Yes.
And I'll be, two or three months long.
Thank you, sir.
But we'll hold the rest of the board who's out here. We'll hold a copy to you for them.
Okay. All right.
Thank you very much.
Sure.
Jesus, conspicuous lack of people.
And I don't know what the status is on the fountain. I haven't heard it. I'm just staying out of that conversation. We're no longer in that conversation, so we're good.
It's been going on long enough, hasn't
it? Yes, long enough.
That was been a dream that it was we were still talking about it.
Yeah.
Wasn't even a hole in the ground, was it?
But Bobby thought that was such just a simple thing. It wasn't that big of a
deal. No.
Boy, did it get complicated. What's the guy's name that's doing the sculpture? He's local, isn't he?
Greg Johnson.
Yeah.
He was there.
Was he there? A long dedication.
It was a little longer than we had. It was supposed to have lasted between 45 minutes and an hour, but I think we went over, 15 to 30 minutes?
Well, reading the essays.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that was a little different.
That looked like They were actually falling asleep standing up.
Yeah, but everybody's standing. Most people standing.
Right.
That's a long dedication for standing.
It was good, though.
Thank goodness the weather was good.
I was so glad the weather was good, because if not, we would have had to move in to the front area there.
Exactly.
That would have been awful.
There he is.
There he is.
Hey, bye.
Only had 1 minute to go.
Yeah, 1 minute to go. Just right on time. Yeah. I didn't waste much time there, did I?
Good morning, Bob. How are you?
Hi, good to see you. You were the swing vote today. We were waiting.
I got here just in time.
You ready to vote?
Yeah.
On anything. The ones you handed out have the date. You corrected the date.
Yes, I put the March.
This is a new update.
Nydia brought those today.
All right, that's nice.
I pronounced your name right, don't I?
Nydia, yes, sir. It rhymes with Lydia.
Is this us?
This is us.
Where's that Tim today? As good as it gets.
He's at the doctor's. Said he had a doctor's appointment this morning.
Oh, okay.
And Joanne's sick. She's got the bronchitis and such. It's fine.
This weather. This weather. Yeah. Don't spread it.
Don't spread it. We don't need it now. Well, we'll go ahead and get started. It's 9 o'clock. Okay. If you'll stand as we always do and start with pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America
and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. All right. Call the meeting to order. First of all, we got a copy of the minutes. If you had a chance to look over them, we'll approve the minutes. I hear a motion.
Hear a motion to approve.
I hear a second.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor signify by aye.
Aye.
Opposed by no. Minutes are approved. Joanne is not here today, so we will dispense with the Secretary of Treasurer's. I don't think there's been any change in the financial statements since the last meeting, actually. So. And the big change that will occur when we pay our portion, when they pull out our portion for the statue, which yes. y'all know that the courthouse was dedicated without statue, and it'll be finished. I think the last word I got was toward the end of summer.
Good.
When Greg will finish that up, and then we'll, as Angie said, we'll do another dedication and do that with our plaque, and our names will be on the plaque. So that'll be a nice thing to do later. One thing I wanted to do today, really the only thing we needed to do today, and I want to go ahead and get it done, we had talked about it a few weeks ago. We really did not have an agreement with Emery and his firm to represent the Development Authority. How long, Emery?
40 years.
4 years. And we seem to have done just fine without it, but it's probably, in this day and time, probably a smart thing to do. So Emery and I, he got started with a draft. We played with it a little bit, and we've come up with an agreement that somewhat mirrors the county agreement with Jim Gerard. It covers a few more things for us. So you've got a copy of it there. The Angie updated it with the date. It's a two-year agreement, which I think is very good. We can have a discussion about it if you would like. The one thing I think we'll probably add was, which the county has on theirs, is a termination clause at the end, at any time at the request of the Development Authority. And we'll add that in. So any motion we make today, let's assume that we will have a termination clause at the end, just like in the county, in the account agreement with Kent. But if you had a chance to look over that, any discussion or questions, we'll do that before we even have a motion. We'll talk about that.
Would it make more sense to make this just, I guess, renewable instead of 2 years and have to come up with a new one? Is it kind of like a lease? You got the option to renew it unless one or the other chooses not to?
Especially if we're going to have a termination clause. We can terminate any
time. Terminate any time.
That's true. That's a good point.
So instead of making 2 years and having to redo it every 2 years, should we just make it read that we have the option to renew it unless one or the other party decides to not to.
I've always served at the pleasure of the board. I can't,
right.
My understanding was y'all can say, enjoy it and goodbye.
We should just have to redo a new contract every 2 years.
Yeah.
We just make it renewable unless one party chooses not to.
Be fine with me.
Okay, let's just do that then. And what I'd like to do is go and act on this today so we can make that part of the motion. Whoever makes the motion, make that part of the motion that we'll amend it. And Andy, if you'll get that done for us and then send it back out. And then I can get with you and sign it anytime. Anything else? Go ahead.
I'll make the motion if there's not any other discussion.
I'll second it.
All right. Motion that we adopt a contract with two changes. It's renewable unless one party decides not to. And the, what was the other one?
The agreement, it is, I guess, the same thing. It can be, I can't remember how the wording was on Kim's, Emory, but it can be terminated any time by the development authority.
This appointment may be terminated any time, with or without cause, upon formal vote of the Board of Commissioners. This is the Commissioners, just agree.
Same thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Yeah. Well, that's my motion.
Right. I'll second that. Yeah, second. All right. Any additional discussion on that? And all in favor of Bobby's motion and amendment, please signify by aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed by no? Very good. We did not ask you to leave the room, Emory, because it's a public meeting, and you could have refused to leave. So we didn't think you would mind. You'd mind sitting there. So that's good. Okay, very good. Well, thank you for doing that for us.
And, I'm glad.
And I think just having an agreement. And that agreement, all y'all know, does include that Angie or anyone, Emory, furnishes us. Our administrative.
Angie's building. Part of the deal, right?
Yeah, absolutely. and we thank you for what you do for us.
It's my pleasure.
So thank you so much. Randall was going to be here. Sometimes he thinks we have other things going, so he doesn't always get here right on time. But let's talk about a couple other things that I kind of added, just a matter of fact things, and then if he makes it fine. He's just going to give an update on budget and the other economic development issues. Let me mention a couple of things. First of all, I did mention the statute, and that will come late summer. And I'm not sure when our money will come out for that, but we've committed, as you know, $50,000 toward that statute.
They'll be sure to let us know when they need it.
They'll let us know when they need it, I'm sure.
Don't worry about
when
that.
When he's ready to be paid. The FEMA's extension, I saw some emails from Angie where the visit was made by
yes.
the state person to FEMA's. And, of course, they really saw the same thing that we saw, moving slowly but making progress. My question is, was it ever approved? Was our extension request approved, or is that a formal matter?
I don't believe it has.
It has not. No, it's not been approved. That's what precipitated the meeting.
Yes, yes.
That was the purpose.
Yes.
Right. So we're waiting. We've made the request.
Right.
So we're waiting for that
DCA
extension to be approved.
They wanted to do a site visit before the extension.
And he didn't seem, the email I read, he didn't seem overly concerned, but he saw the same thing we did.
Mm-hmm.
Good. And I'm glad he made that. I'm glad somebody else saw it. So. Okay, very good. Scientific Games, their tax abatement expired December 31st, and we thought we were going to take action on that, but I guess that we deed that.
It automatically, well, it doesn't automatically, we've got to transfer it back.
Okay.
Yeah, and then they've asked that.
Okay, so.
I asked them, didn't they want to go again?
Yeah. So anyway, you will do that.
Yes,
that's really nothing
touch.
We have to act on the board.
No,
that has to be done.
That's right. So I think that's an automatic based on the prior bond issue.
And then we won't have anything going with them.
No, that's right.
At this time. Okay.
New York Life's also tax abatement expired
in the year. Oh, it expired same time? Okay. But again, those are not actions we have to take. You'll do the same thing.
That's right.
Okay, very good. Okay. Couple things at the legislature. Senate Bill 85. I don't know how many of you follow what's going on down there. Senate Bill 85. It's really just a bill introduced by Brandon Beach, Senator Beach from over in North Fulton, that clarifies what development authorities can do. So several years ago, back in the early 90s, when the Development Authority Act was passed, they listed 13 individual things that they could do, and then they added a general statement later, and it's just been a confusing thing. So Senator Beach introduced a bill to kind of clear up some confusion of what a development authority can do. Does not diminish what they can do, it just makes it a general category versus 13 specific things.
Okay.
So it's just a cleanup, and it's passed by the Senate, it's in the House. If you see any of our representatives mention that to them, it's a good thing for the development authority. It's just a clarification, but it's getting some questions in the House right now. The other one was House Bill 97. That was a non-disclosure bill that was introduced in the House, and it was withdrawn. And that would have been basically that you could not have non-disclosure, like a development authority made negotiated with a client for something, a tax abatement, a bond, or whatever. You had to disclose everything, and that bill was withdrawn, which is what we would have recommended would be withdrawn.
Well, that's always been our policy anyway.
Yeah.
Even if it wasn't the law.
That's right. So anyway, those are the only two things that were in the legislature, and we're still waiting on the 85. 85 wouldn't have a huge impact on us one way or the other. It's a cleanup for the authorities. Okay. That's really all I have today. Anything else? I hate to, I know it'll happen. Randall will come walking in here. But again, his was simply an update. There was no issue that had to be discussed from Randall's standpoint, and we can certainly do that next time. The main thing I want to do is get this agreement done. Angie, if you'll get, you call me and I'll drop by, and we'll go ahead and get that signed and filed and ready to go. So,
Emory, will that release of the Scientific Games in New York Life, will that need to be signed by the authority?
Yes. Okay. And it's authorized in the bond issue that when it was terminated.
It's an automatic, it doesn't need approval, but it'll need signature.
We need to deed that, yeah. That's correct.
Okay.
I'm waiting on their attorney, Ben, I forget Ben's last name, but anyway, he's in the process of sending that to us.
Okay.
And then we'll wait on the approval on the things, which I'm assuming shouldn't be a deed issue at this point. Okay, Angie, anything from you? Well, this could be the shortest meeting of all time.
Pretty close.
I told you, wait, I told you, there he is right there.
Oh, there he is.
Okay. Boy, you got your just in the nick of time. We've just fixed the adjourn.
I would really hate to end the meeting before 9:15. I really would. So anyway, have you got a couple things to share with us this morning?
Want to provide just a brief update on how we ended the year last year. As you know, each quarter we provided the board with really just the stats of how we were doing for the year and what economic development projects had come in and the economic impact that was generated from those. And as you might remember, we measure economic development in terms of the number of jobs and capital investment that's generated from each project. And glad to say, last year was a phenomenal year. Several things happened in the marketplace. Banks began to lend a little bit more. A lot more of the folks who were sitting on the sideline who'd weathered the economic downturn by cross-training employees and actually growing their companies through sales as opposed to lending began to see much of the movement in their growth really come to fruition. And we were able to participate in 23 economic development projects successfully last year, which was phenomenal. The collective total of jobs generated, you can see on the top, was 1,047 new jobs and a total capital investment level of $104 million in new capital investment. And that's derived from manufacturing companies, healthcare corporations, as well as technology firms. And then also we had a few small businesses who actually expanded and did some great things in the community as well. So really all of our industry sectors really moved forward in a dynamic way. What's unique, if you take a look at the charts that are listed below, in terms of the type of projects, this was the year, or last year rather, was the year when recruitment projects came back. Typically during the downturn we saw much of our economic development efforts really focus on expanding local businesses. We looked internally because many other companies just weren't seeking to make a move into our market, or into any market for that matter, during the downturn. But the year before last, we began to see that trickle start to move on the recruitment side. And then it really came in full speed last year. And the international market played a major role with that. We thank the Development Authority for their support of helping us to host red carpet tours in conjunction with our partners in Germany, France, and then also in Canada as well. And look to do that again this year. We're seeing some dividends coming out of that. Also on the capital investment side, you see the levels of capital investment have increased, in part because with expansion projects, you typically see folks make purchases such as equipment or go through training. But on the recruitment side, when we're bringing new companies into the community, that's where the larger capital investment thresholds come from building purchases and land acquisition. And we anticipate that that's going to continue into this year as well. A very unique thing happened last year. In the fourth quarter, we had our largest industrial property in Forsyth County acquired by a phenomenal company, a technology firm called Prosys. As a result of their lease, it put us in a position where we really had to start talking to developers about the opportunity to develop land and actually build new products. In our opportunity zone, we actually reached over 90% occupancy last year as well, which was fantastic. But what that means is now is a phenomenal time to build in Forsyth County on the commercial, office, and industrial side. So we started talking to developers about that a bit more, including the Veterans Memorial site and a few other sites that are located throughout the community. And we have some interest also from business park developers who seen the growth in our market. So hopefully by the middle of the second quarter, or towards the end of it rather, we'll have an update for you from a few developers who are looking in the area, and they'll come and just talk a bit about some of the things they're interested in. And then you see the job count. Again, on the recruitment side, as new jobs came into the area from the companies we had recruited, they actually hired at a faster rate. And what was very impressive is each of the companies we worked with last year all wanted to make sure that they could hire locally. So we partnered with the Georgia Department of Labor to confidentially host a series of job fairs for them. And many of those took place over at the Conference Center at Lanier Technical College. And we were able to see some significant hires here right out of the community. And if we take a look at kind of the flow of the projects versus the unemployment rate, there was a direct correlation there. Currently, our unemployment rate is at about 4.8% as compared to the national rate of about 5%, and then Georgia's kind of hovers around 6%. So again, a great year. Like we said, collectively, recruitment projects really began to come back, and that helped push the numbers a bit higher than they were in previous years. But we worked on 23 projects generating 1,047 new jobs and $104 million in new capital investment. For the year to come, we anticipate that manufacturing is going to be a major player for us. We're starting to see many of the vending opportunities or subcontracting opportunities for the heavier hitters that moved into the market in the past 5 years in Georgia begin to look down towards a lot of the local firms. A great example, a local company off of Setting Down Road has received, as you know, the contract to make all the plastic grills for Kia. And because of that relationship, they're now beginning to work with several other automotive manufacturers. So we think auto is going to be a major player for us as well, but not necessarily in terms of landing an automotive manufacturing plant, but the subsidiary and vendor contracting that'll come from it. That's going to play a huge role for us. Also, medical equipment manufacturing is beginning to be on the upswing again. And as our local hospitals look to expand, we think there's some opportunities there to just focus on recruiting more companies to move closer to the mothership, if you will. And then also on the technology side, we're beginning to see many startups who came into fruition during the downturn, almost out of necessity. Startups that were led by individuals who didn't necessarily graduate from college earlier as the traditional startup mode suggests, where you graduate from college, come out of a high-level technical school, and then focus on developing software or product and then launch it and sell the company. These new startups that are emerging now that we think will kind of grow this year really were started by individuals who graduated college earlier, worked 10, 15, maybe 20 years within a company, and then during the downturn, instead of going and looking for new job opportunities, decided to form their own team. And there's some great examples of that out there. And one that we're working very closely with is a lighting company that actually emerged out of the closure of the space program. Several folks who were working on, I guess, the lights for the space shuttles had come up with a concept on how to commercialize that product after that was phased out. And they moved the company to Forsyth County, and we anticipate that they'll see some growth here this year. And I'll put names to these companies as we go forward. Just some of these, just at the moment, have asked if they can stay confidential. And then after technology, we also anticipate, again, that the international market will start to kind of kick into gear right around third quarter, which is the trend that we've typically seen. This year already, we've hosted one inbound trade mission that included companies that have ties to the poultry sector. So not necessarily poultry processing companies, but companies, for example, that make the antibiotics for the poultry industry, and some that do equipment or machinery. And we partnered with the Trade Ministry of Quebec and hosted a confidential tour of Tyson's. Tyson's was gracious enough to open their doors and just share, you know, what our community has done and how we've grown over the last several years as it relates to manufacturing and what they've done internally. And it was a great ambassadorial effort. I think the neat thing about it was we got a chance to sit and listen to a few companies from Belgium and from France have in-depth discussions about poultry with the plant managers over at Tyson's. And you'd have thought everybody grew up in North Georgia. It's amazing once the topic really starts going. And I think from that trade mission, we're now looking at actually recruiting one of those companies here because they recognize that their product is something that the poultry industry in North Georgia could really take advantage of. We have a technology trade mission coming up in April, and I'll get with Angie to forward the dates out to you about that. And we'd love for you to just chat with some of the companies. We anticipate that we'll have four of my counterparts in Canada, economic development representatives who are more focused on establishing trade relations as opposed to recruiting folks to go to Canada. And then we'll have about six companies as well. But we anticipate that that'll be pretty significant. And Siemens, as well as the Canadian Standards Association Lighting Lab that's here in Forsyth County, have already volunteered to host tours of their facilities during that. So we'll make sure you get the dates and the times. Love for you to join us for that as well. And then on the budget,
I was going to say, I thought it was ironic the other day with a great courthouse opening and all the dignitaries out there. Crowd. I wish I could have gotten a picture. The poultry truck pulled up right behind the big crowd. It just sat there for a few minutes. That's a classic right there. There's our chickens. There's our new courthouse. I wish I could have stepped back and got a picture of the chickens with the courthouse.
Randall, one question on this sheet.
Yes, sir.
The types of project, capital investment, jobs, et cetera, the bulk of it is from successful recruitment projects.
Yes, sir.
Is that projects that have actually on the ground here or just proposed and haven't actually put something on the ground?
These are folks who have their doors opening and are working today.
Okay.
So these are the companies who we consider it a closed deal. And we still have companies in the pipeline that you know, are about to enter into that closed phase, but what we wanted to report were just things that were definitely closed and folks who had already started hiring and already started producing their products.
Okay, good.
And for this year, we didn't change anything. This is exactly in sync with the budget proposal that was generated and we reviewed last year. Again, we see the CoStar cost there as the first line item. And I can't express enough how appreciative we are to be able to use that product. It's given us the opportunity almost in real time to identify sites and buildings for clients. And that's just something we didn't have access to before. And the real estate features there also allow us to be able to contact those who represent those properties much more quickly. It's outstanding. So we appreciate that, we truly do. And then in terms of advertisements, we still had that budget there so we could market some of the county's assets to the public a little bit. Marketing material, every 2 years or so, traditionally the Development Authority looks at creating new publications that just talk a little bit about the community and that can be used to show clients and talk about the Development Authority's property tax abatement incentive. So we'll just need to update that a little bit. And then the spring and fall conferences for the Georgia Economic Development Authority, the Georgia Economic Developers Association. And again, those are the two conferences where typically the project managers who work for the Georgia Department of Economic Development are all in attendance. And it's a rare thing to get them all at one location at one time. So that gives us an opportunity to showcase our community's business advantages to that group all at once. And then the last year, the board asked for us to take another look at attending and even speaking at the medical equipment conference that happens in the fall of each year, the FIND conference. And we had last year several local Forsyth County companies that participated in the event. That's how we learned or caught wind of it. And I think this year we're working on trying to put together a panel that can go down and talk about the value of expanding your company. And then since there was such a large international presence there last year, we're also going to talk about how to move your company into the U.S. market. And we think that'll generate some interest from companies who will be in attendance at the conference and give us a chance to do a little recruiting again. And then overall, again, the budget stayed the same in terms of the total. And then we had the red carpet tours and then the SAE World Congress and Expo. It's the automotive heavyweight conference. And we're still trying to identify a few local companies who participated in this. We think we have a few. The company I mentioned that works with Kia was familiar with it, so we might be able to pick their brain a little bit in terms of strategy on how to engage folks at that conference as well.
I think the last couple of years we've gotten a little out of sync with our expenses versus our budget on calendar year, but this looks like this is calendar year.
Yes, sir.
This is pretty focused on calendar year 15, so I think we confused ourselves where we were the last couple of years, but this should be done in 15, so that's good. We're really starting fresh. Okay. Any questions? Randall? All right, great. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks.
Commissioner Bob was in here, but he stepped back out. I was going to ask him, but he missed his chance.
Anything else coming forward this morning? All right, motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor, second. How about
aye? Aye.
Very good. Have a safe day. Thank you.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. 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 Yeah
Today's tonight.
We have a little bit of
mission. This is the way I would forward describe it. The mission take the guy out. Giving us the charge.
They could still have a decent finish. It's not getting them out of the lost land. This year.
Something like that. It's got to generate something out of return.
I'm giving it a time warp.
They don't want to turn on the rest of the bank.
Did you want to try one?
No.
She took it to me.
Stay around home. Enjoy your house.
She bought this new phone.
Oh, how wonderful. Oh, yes, there was a beautiful tan. Not too hot.
I had a lot of laying up.
I got a call from her. She said, I think I'm going to
take a lot. All right. See you later.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Good to see you, Randall. Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thanks.
Bye-bye. I'll take you. Thank you. I'll be in touch.
All right, thank you. So I really should have called her, but I'll call her.
Okay.
Just let her know. This is very different where we need to hit first.
Okay.
Without talking, really no specific to talk about. But, and I doubt that Jeff had an issue. I don't know that he even brought it up. If we need to, we'll chat with him if we need to do that.
I think this was more from them.
Yeah, this is what some Jane had been thinking about for a long time. Yeah. It's not a bad idea.
Mm-mm. And we've got one developer, not a developer, but there's an international company that's interested in property tax abatements. So we'll want to get an introduction to them. So.
Okay. All right, we'll do.
James and I met with them.
Did you have another one of those red books?
I gave them all out that I had.
I'll get Angie to give them. You got it. Good deal.
Thank you for asking.
All right.
Byron.
You have a good day.
Good to see you, Mr. Seago.